Okay, we've had some issues. Not only have I had some issues getting Darkest Dungeon to capture properly, I also had some issues getting OBS to stream properly all of a sudden. So sometimes it takes a little technical wizardry to get anything to do anything. I think we're okay now. I think. I hope so. Again, I kind of had to mess with some stuff, so. We're just going to be doing a different form of capture on Darkest Dungeon, and I hope it works. We're going to find out. So, let's see. Right, I'm going to get my face out of here and watch the intro since I messed that up the first time.
Ruin has come to our family. You remember our venerable house? Opulent and imperial, gazing proudly from its stoic perch above the moor. I lived all my years in that ancient, rumor-shadowed manor, fattened by decadence and luxury. And yet, I began to tire of conventional extravagance. Singular, unsettling tales suggested the mansion itself was a gateway to some fabulous and unnameable power. With relic and ritual, I bent every effort towards the excavation and recovery of those long-buried secrets, exhausting what remained of our family fortune on swarthy workmen and sturdy shovels. At last, in the salt-soaked crags beneath the lowest foundations, we unearthed that damnable portal of antediluvian evil. Our every step unsettled the ancient earth, but we were in a realm of death and madness. In the end, I alone fled laughing and wailing through those blackened arcades of antiquity. Until consciousness failed me. You remember our venerable house? Opulent and imperial. It is a festering abomination. I beg you, return home, claim your birthright, and deliver our family from the ravenous, clutching shadows of the Darkest Dungeon.
All right, with that out of the way, let us once again recreate our game.
You will arrive along the old road. It winds with a troubling, serpent-like suggestion through the corrupted countryside, leading only, I fear, to ever more tenebrous places. There is a sickness in the ancient, pitted cobbles of the old road, and on its writhing path, you will face viciousness, violence, and perhaps other damnably transcendent terrors. So steel yourself, and remember there can be no bravery without madness. The old road will take you to hell, but in that gaping abyss, we will find our redemption.
Okay, I think this is gonna work. Yay. Okay, good, good, good.
Brigands have run up these lanes. Keep to the side path.
The hamlet is just ahead.
I just wanted to watch the cinematics again because I enjoy them thoroughly.
That all may hear of your arrival.
Yeah, that definitely took some effort. And OBS kind of freaked out the first time I tried to switch the capture method on the fly, so couldn't tell you why that was exactly, but not gonna worry about it. It's working now. It's all that counts. All right, so
leave nothing unchecked. There is much to be found in forgotten places. An ambush. Send these vermin a message. The rightful owner has returned, and their kind is no longer welcome.
Yeah, okay. See, Darkest Dungeon is very difficult, because not only is the gameplay difficult, also just getting it to do what you want occasionally is a little tricky. Well, that didn't work. Let's see if I can stun him again. Man, come on! Alright.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
Went a little better the first time we tried it, but that's alright. Everybody will live, and that's all that matters. I have seen people wipe on their on a run through the tutorial, which is sad, but it does happen. Okie dokie. You know what? I don't remember if you can use a key. This thing is trapped. I don't think you can use a key to bypass that. I think it'll just give me an error and say no. Oh, apparently you can. I got a protection stone and an unmovable helmet. Wow. Move resist and move skill chance for bounty hunter. That's actually quite nice. It's only common, but it's pretty decent. Okay, I will take that and we will go. Quick draw! +4 speed on first round. That's nice. Speed is actually a pretty decent stat.
Welcome home, such as it is. This squalid hamlet, these corrupted lands, they are yours now, and you are bound to them.
Okay, so here's the new caretaker goals. Which are just succeed in your first, second, third assaults on the Darkest Dungeon and complete the final Darkest Dungeon quest. I don't know what any of those are, but obviously your roster goals are to get one of everyone up to level 6. And these are all the bosses along the way, which are just... most of these are just, you know, duplicates of... previous bosses, they just get tougher. I got your activity log over here, which has almost nothing in it so far. We've got our two dudes. Let's see, go to the stagecoach.
Women and men, soldiers and outlaws, fools and corpses. All will find their way to us now that the road is clear.
Let's see, what kind of upgrades can I do? I'll start with that.
Arrive, foolishly seeking fortune and glory. in this domain of the damned.
This has all the story stuff.
The tragic extent of my failings.
It's kind of cool because even though these, for instance, right here, you see the Brigand 8 pounder, 12, and 16 pounder. Those are all essentially the same boss, just more difficult versions of it. But you get little story beats for each one that talk a little bit about, you know, the ancestors' nonsense. So, you know, there's a bunch of little, not like a ton of story, but kind of a little something to let you know what's going on. Graveyard, obviously. No one there yet. Here,
covered in the poisoned earth.
So what's all this?
Awaiting merciful oblivion.
I don't know. Oh, is that like a quick select? For like different... It is. Oh, that's cool. I'm fairly sure this is new. I'm pretty sure. Like a quick select for different... for the different town screens. That's pretty cool. Alright. Cool. Well, I guess we can embark since there is really nothing else to do.
Madness and morbidity. Your work begins.
Okay. We do have some trinkets. Oops. We do have some trinkets. We got that for the bounty hunter and a protection stone. Guess we could equip that on him. He gets that plus 4 speed on the first round. So, okay.
The cost of preparedness measured now.
Let's see.
Later, in blood.
Sort of forget what everything does. These items are actually more than just recovery items. You can use them on different things within the dungeon itself, which will net you certain bonuses and stuff. Hey JC man, how's it going? This is Darkest Dungeon, which just came out of early access today, and I'm super excited about it, so I wanted to give it a go. Alright. It's been a while since I played this, so I'm gonna have to sort of figure this out again. You are very correct. I did forget to change my title. Good call, man. There we go. I do forget these things. Okay. Well, that's a great start. Let's see. Forget what all of these abilities do. Okay.
Ghoulish horrors, brought low and driven into the mud.
All right, good deal. Good thing we brought a shovel.
Even the cold stone seems bent on preventing passage.
Oops. Well, that was foolish. For some reason, I saw the shovel, and I thought that it had automatically filled the slot with the shovel, and it didn't. So that was kind of a waste. But that's alright. We're just gonna have to deal with it. Alright, we're surprised, so that shuffles the party order, which is always wonderful. I do not like these chicks at all. So... I'll take her out as soon as possible. What kind of damage does this do? 2 to 5? Okay. Okay, good, he resisted. I don't need any more party order nonsense going wrong here. Man, he doesn't have any of the movement stuff. I'll just keep doing this.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Alright, so what's the blinding gas? Oh, that's the stun. Yeah, we'll try for the stun since she's already blighted.
A death by inches.
Well, this could have gone better, couldn't it?
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter. As victories mount, so too will resistance.
I'm playing it a little risky, and I'm sort of letting the torch go down, which didn't work out for me so well that time, but I tend to play a little fast and loose with the torch. Still got a scout, so that's alright. Let's head up for the treasure. You get higher loot chance, and it's sort of a risk-reward sort of thing. Great, thanks, Reynald, you asshole. I did not realize he had negative traits. I forget how you look at their stuff. I thought there was a way to do it. No? I thought there was a way to actually look at their... There it is. Yeah, he's a kleptomaniac, prone to stealing. A god-fearing kleptomaniac. Gotta love that.
Secrets and wonders can be found in the most tenebrous corners of this place.
We're not surprised, so that's okay. I'm gonna try and take this chick out quick.
Powerful blow.
Nice crit. Ah, that's a shame. That's a shame. Resist there. Let's see.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
Youch. Man.
Now the true test. Hold fast or expire.
Yes, death's door, we know. Just can't hit anybody here. Get him out of death's door. And what is that? Tiba. Oh, that is Death's door. Looked like he still had it, but it was grayed out, so that's a lot. Death's door recovery. Huh, so once you go down to Death's door, there is now a negative status effect for coming out of it that lasts to the end of the quest. So once you go down that far, your dude's kind of critically wounded for the rest of the quest to some degree, which is, I think, new. I don't know if that's new for release or new for the last content update. And JC Man, the torch is kind of the risk-reward system for this game. You can see up here, like right now, my stress is high, the monster accuracy and damage is high, and the chance that my guys will be surprised is high, but I get potentially better loot and potentially better crit chance. So normally one wants to play with higher torch levels, generally speaking. But it's not usually that bad. This has not gone particularly well. But I like to kind of play it a little risky, and sometimes it works out, but not always.
Triumphant pride precipitates a dizzying fall.
Get some extra loot here. Book of Relaxation. Minus stress damage, plus to accuracy, minus to dodge. Okay. Can I actually give this to someone mid-dungeon? Apparently I can. Let's see, he needs a bandage. Well, this definitely could be going better, so, we'll boost our torchlight back up here. We'll go back this way. Already got that pack. You can see here we did some scouting, so it sort of reveals like some of what is on the map there, but not everything. It depends on how good your scouting is, I guess. What do we got? Holy water and antivenom. Neither of which we probably need too much right now, but... Man, I forget what that does. Alright, battlefield medicine, no. Molding vapors. I think that would do well here. Three to seven, you can do it. And she can judge this dude. Does she have a stun? She does not have a stun. Yeesh! Man! That is rough. Okay. Thank God. Thank God for that dodge. Oh man, really? That's a shame. Okie dokie. Man. What is this negative penalty? It's only minus two. It's not horrible. But less speed, a little less damage, and extra stress. Try that again. There we go. Precision and power. Alright. Got some stuff.
Seize this momentum.
Holy fountain.
Push on to the task's end.
I honestly don't remember what these do. I can cheat and look it up on the wiki. which at some point I'm going to have to start doing that because this game is really hard and you need to know what these things do. And it's, I knew a lot of this stuff at one point, but I kind of forgot. So, you know, I'm just going to look it up. I'm not going to worry about it. Was that Holy Fountain? Okay, it was Holy Water. I thought it was Holy Water, but then I had second-guessed myself. And no item gives you potential loot. Alright. Well, I do have some Holy Water, so we will use that. I should have had him use it. That was foolish. Again, I need to sort of get my sea legs again with this game, because I kind of forget how a lot of this stuff works. You'd think I would remember it all after 50 hours of play, but no. Okay, let's see. Who's got... where is the... Where's the trap? Oh, there it is. 50% for him. I think he's going to be the highest. Yeah, far and away. Even though it's a risk... He's got the best shot, so that's good. Nobody here. So this should be no problem for us to finish this off. Oh wow, lots of food. Everybody eats. Use that last torch, and I don't think there's going to be anybody in here, and we should get out. Alright, done. Success! Alright, I'm pleased with that. I'm pleased. Let's see what we get. Hey! All good stuff. He hates beasts. Minus 20% stress damage of torch above 75, and plus 2 speed of torch below 26. Cool.
Curiosity, interest, and obsession.
Alright. Tavern's now unlocked, and the abbey is unlocked. Road to damnation. Good deal. Let's see who's in the stagecoach. I guess I'll just take everybody at this point.
This man understands that adversity and existence are one and the same.
Alright, so one of the fun things here is you can rename your heroes. So... Let's get you guys in the game. Let's see what else we got here. He is a lurker, plus 10% damage of torch below 26. Plus 2 speed, and that's if torch above 75. Plotter. Faded. That's pretty good. Scrounge. Flood release. Where's the spot? Yeah, okay. Alright, well, let's see. The abbey is now available.
The cobwebs have been dusted, the pews set straight. The abbey calls to the faithful.
Let's see, we can start with... Start doing those two.
Robe, claiming and... communion with the divine. Madness.
Let's see. That's a little on the expensive side. We'll go with it. Everybody else is okay. Boy. Let's see, we also have the tavern. Fresh kegs, cards, and curtained rooms. I don't really need to throw anybody else in there right now. Nothing else is unlocked currently, so we'll just keep going. Oh, come on, guys. Don't be wimps here. Oh, wow. The it has selected the darkest dungeon here, which clearly, no, we are not going to be doing that. That is some awful, awful nonsense. I don't know why it auto-selected that. I don't even know why I can go there. That's kind of strange that it lets you go right off the bat. Actually, I seem to recall them saying, like, yeah, we'll let you just go to the darkest dungeon straight away if you want to just see how awful it is and get yourself killed. Which is kind of funny. Snake oil. Bust and some gold. 100% of rune battles. Okay, let's see what she has here. She has suppressing fire. Sniper shot. Blind fire. Battlefield bandage. Okay. He's going to want to be up front. What can he do from the back? All that does is move him forward. She can do the sniper shot from the back and suppressing fire and blind fire. Okay, so she's actually fine in the back. And this guy can do harvest, battle ballad, and inspiring tune. Okay. This may not go super well. We'll find out. Let's see. That's interesting. Why do I have things in my... in here already, in my provisions. I saw someone in another chat on another stream earlier mentioned something about free provisions, so I guess this must be it, that certain guys bring certain provisions with them, I guess, which is cool. Get one of those, say... 7 torches, maybe 8 torches since this is combat. Shovel. And this is interesting. I also don't remember him having like an inventory. So it appears there's only so much stuff that you can buy. I guess that's a way of them mitigating, you know, you just being able to buy like a ton of stuff. I guess I don't need that. And I'll get it. Well, I don't really need an anti-venom. That should do. And maybe another bandage. Yeah, I should definitely. One more bandage. I don't have a healer on this run. So, that would be wise. And one key.
The fiends must be driven back. And what better place to begin than the seat of our noble line?
Oh, that's a great start. That's a great start. Great start. Bookshelf. I want to say bookshelves are not worth taking. And this... I'm going to look that up as well. Because I can't remember. I want to say it's a shovel. Uh, 100% quirk. Oh, okay, I was wrong. The other thing I thought was holy water, so. Alright, well, let's use our holy water. Got some good stuff off that. I try not to abuse the wiki too much with this, but again, I've just forgotten a lot of this, and I sort of feel I don't really want to penalize myself too much. This is a short one, we'll just go. Okay, we're going to pass that up, since we don't have any more holy water. Good thing we didn't use the shovel.
The cold stone seems bent on preventing passage.
Yeah, what the heck? Why did that not work? Did I not do it properly? It didn't use the shovel. Maybe I'm supposed to actually click on the shovel? I guess that must be it. Well, that's really dumb. I don't know if that's different or not. I can't remember. I remember putting the item in the thing and then clicking the use icon and it would use whatever you have in the slot. Maybe now you're supposed to click on the item? I don't know if that's changed or if I'm just forgetting. I may just be forgetting. Nothing over here, so that was a great waste of stress and health. It's pretty sweet. So yeah, idle, you know, learn from my example. Don't do the stupid things that I'm doing here. Oh, cool, another trap.
Mechanical hazards.
Man.
Possessed by evil intent.
No combat yet, and she's already at half health. I'm going to avoid the books. Books, I think, have a chance to give you, like, maybe something good or, like, negative quirks. I seem to remember them generally not being worth the trade-off. I could be wrong. A lot of this stuff could have been tweaked. Okay. Let's see what else. See, that moves him forward. I don't want that. What kind of damage does this do? 2 to 4? Man. I think I will try and stress heal her a little bit. Yeesh.
Is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Okay. Not so bad, but not great either. Heal 2 to 3. Plus 20% heals received. But she can't do it to herself? She can't do it to herself. So I guess it's blind fire. Man. Idle, what's going on? You're failing me here. Oh, boy. Well, I could probably kill it. Yeah, I can probably kill it.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Okay, good. We'll move him back. And move on. Man, sure wish I had brought an antidote. Altar of Light. This I don't remember at all. This I don't remember at all. What do you say, JC? Roll the dice. Hey, Soothing Pale Light. That's good. Plus 20% damage. Awesome. Okay, this is less than wonderful. Yeah, always roll, right? Always roll the dice. Maybe not always. see, what is... I don't have great stun resist. Let's see if I can stun him. I want to take these guys out, because these guys suck. This is better because it causes bleed, but these guys can't bleed, so... But I'm still gonna do it. Okay, that's still a pretty good result. Ouch. Yikes!
The end approaches.
Alright, she can battlefield medicine him. Try and keep him from dying. Thank God for that stun. See if he can kill him off this time. Dang. Not quite. Oh, this is gonna suck.
As life ebbs, terrible vistas of emptiness reveal themselves.
Alright, use that grape shot. Oh my God. That is less than ideal. I gotta take somebody out here. Shoot. He got the dodge. Man. Do I go for the kill or do I go for the stun? I go for the stun. I have two guys that can hit both of these guys in the middle row and take them out next turn. So we'll avoid that guy's damage.
Teetering. Great. On the brink, facing the abyss.
Great. Grape shot. Don't miss. Idle. Don't miss.
Press this advantage.
Thank you.
Give them no quarter.
Yeah. Stop doing that! Please stop doing that. That would be my phone, which I forgot to turn off notifications for. Oh man. Let's try to take this jerk out.
Injury and despondence set the stage for heroism. Or cowardice.
See, Idle, you can do stuff from the back row there. So I will try this. Just to get a little something else in there. Take him out.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
And this isn't super great. Let's see who he goes for. Alright. Still okay, but he can't hit anybody. So that is a bit pointless. Kind of a waste. Okay, snipe him, please. There we go. Take that stuff. I do not have... I do not have any holy water. Oops. I don't want you guys to swap places. Arbalest. Just give it a whirl. Alright, well, there was some stuff in there at least. Yeah, corpses take more than one turn to kill, usually. So sometimes it's worth it, sometimes it's not. Again, I don't know how they balance things currently, but it used to be that they would kind of take a little while to get rid of. Well, we have some food, so we can at least get them out of death's door. How many more rooms to go? Two more. Who can say how many fights? So... It's tough without a healer. When things go as bad as they have gone so far. Oh, good. Oh, good. And we're surprised. This is... This is not good.
Those who covet injury find it in no short supply.
Good dodge. What the hell can this guy even do from the front row? He can stab. That's basically it. That's basically it. That is not where I want him. Such a bummer. I want to see... I can't kill this guy, probably, but... he'll be dead next turn. Ouch.
Reeling, about to break.
Let's see, he's only got 3 hit points. And only 2 points of bleed. Take a shot. Hey, good. We're good. Let's see, where's our stuff? He's a bandage on him. Just leave that open. And grape shot. Ah.
Perched at the very precipice of oblivion.
Ugh, it's so painful, I'm gonna waste moves. Life is made true through suffering. This chick is real upbeat. Can't even hit him. All I can really do is blind fire. Maybe I will just heal him instead. Oh, crap. Oh, man. He can't shoot the front row from the back? Oh, that's terrible. Lady, you are pissing me off. So it really won't let me switch? No, it won't. That sucks. And I can't do anything with this either. Well, we'll just do that. Just in case this guy survives the next turn. Get a bleed on him. Does that bleed? No, it doesn't bleed. I hope this is the last fight. Yes, Idol. Camping has the potential to heal. I mean, you get to use camping skills during camping. So, when you camp, you can use the various skills of your heroes, as well as... oh, he already went. As well as you get to eat. So depending on your food stocks, you get... you know, you can either, like, feast or just eat normal, and you get more bonuses based on how much food surplus you use, basically. Shoot, well, just try it. Dang it. So yeah, there's a variety of things you can do while camping. The unfortunate part is that... man, it sucks. Oh, thank God he dodged. We can't camp on this run because it's a short run. You can only camp on certain runs.
So too will resistance.
Well, that means... oh, this wasn't even a room battle, was it? Shoot. Alright, well, some food. And this time we're not going to make the same stupid mistake with the shovel. We're going to click the shovel icon. It works a lot better that way. I feel like those things are bad. I'm gonna leave that alone. But yeah, camping is interesting. It changes the dynamic quite a bit. Well, we know there's gonna be a fight. That means we're gonna have to do two fights. Because this mission is to complete 100% of room battles. And there's only one more room. So... oh, that's really unfortunate. That's really unfortunate. Can't eat any more food because I'm sure we're going to get hungry one more time before this is over. Okay, there's going to be one more fight here. I hope it's a wimpy one.
The match is struck. A blazing
star is born. Okay, we got a free round. That's something at least. Let's see. Stun him. We'll shoot the dude in the back. You can do that. Ugh. Let's see. I'll risk it here. Hey! That worked out. I'm okay with that. So I'll just heal him. Need to do what I can for heals here. Ugh, so close. So he can't hit the front with that, but he can with that. We're good. Okay. That worked out.
Seize this momentum. Push on to the task's end.
We're almost there. Just got one more fight. Depending on how bad a fight it is, this could be a disaster. Just eat the rest of the food. Alright, this isn't great. He's about to go over the edge. Oh, nice!
Many fall in the face of chaos, but not this one. Not today.
Well, that's pretty cool. Do love when that happens. Man. I'm just gonna try and kill off this dude. The damage, I think, is the worst at this point. By far. Wow, look at all that stress heal. All the way down to 26. That's fantastic. Alright, she can bleed. So maybe this will get a bleed on her. Yes, good. Let me try for a stun. Good. Oof. Ouch.
And now the true test. Hold fast or expire.
Snipe him, please. Please. Thank you. Let's get rid of... I don't know. Let's get a lead on that guy. OK. Okay. Uh-oh. Please resist. You didn't resist. Okay. That's not what I was hoping for. That's the worst thing for me in this game. This is like the most annoying stuff is the stuff where they pull you out of position.
Feeding the evil therein.
One down, but at least these guys are probably gonna live through this. I think.
A devastating blow.
And no, JC, I didn't. I don't. Let me check right now. To see if I even have a message from you. No, man, I still don't have a message from you. I don't know where you're sending it, but it's not coming through. Okay, that's it.
At least promises
we'll check this box. We still have a key. So we'll get a little more goodies out of this. And that's great. Now we can leave. Well, we lost one.
More bones,
which is a shame. But
devils remanded to their
we lived through it. We made some money. And got some resources. So, okay, minus 20 stress and wield, and minus 5 accuracy range skilled. Considering she's ranged, that's not so great.
We dug for months, years.
JC Mania on Twitch.
And we were rewarded with madness.
Yes, you both lived. You both lived, Idol. So, that is certainly preferable. Alright, we got the blacksmith, we got the guild. She recovered a whole mess of stress. He recovered a good amount. So they're good to go. Our arbalist is effed, shall we say? I think I'm actually just going to dismiss her. Because she has this, which I don't want to pay to remove, and she's like at max stress here. It's probably not worth keeping her around. Probably. Let's see who else is here. Got another highwayman. I still don't see an alert, JC man. Oh wait, no, there it is. There it is. Okay, yeah, I got your message this time. Okay, so well, let's see. The occultist is not really what I would want right now, but I guess I'll take him. I always enjoy a good highwayman here. Yeah. Okay. Light sensitive, minus damage if torch above 75. And the Cove Explorer. And Grave Robbers, I have not yet figured out how to use particularly well. So I'm not really quite sure how they work, but
to those with a keen eye, gold gleams like a dagger's point.
Yeah, and I think I'm just going to dismiss her.
Slumped shoulders, she can take wild eyes, and a stumbling gait. This one is no more good to us.
Now get another for the hero barracks.
The bellows blast once again. The forge stands ready to make weapons of war. Make no mistake, we will face ever greater threats. Our soldiers must be ready.
Let's see. That's strike two. Trying to remember which of these different, you got your busts, portraits, deeds, and crests, which you use to level everything up. You kind of have to manage, you know, which ones you use for which, since some are shared between different buildings, you know, but each one will use different stuff on its upgrade path, so you kind of have to plan how you want this to go, and your caretaker likes to take up a slot most of the time, which can make things a little bit difficult in the early going as well. Alright, well, I will improve the bar. Ale,
maybe they can be inured against the horrors below.
And send Idle in there. Guild reduces cost of skill training by 10%. What do you get by default? You can't train to level 2 in anything, I guess, until you get this.
A strict regimen is paramount if one is to master the brutal arithmetic of combat.
So this will give us more accuracy, and that's it. This will give us more accuracy and slightly better stun chance. That's probably useful. About this guy, I might want to get a different, unlock a different skill for him at some point, because he was kind of, I forget what everything does. Maybe instead of blinding gas is stun. That's right. I don't know, it's not terrible. Can increase his stun chance. We'll go for that. Maybe emboldening vapors also. It's an extra speed, that's pretty good. What does this give me? Potential for an extra heal? Okay, I'll take that. And see, we'll look at this chick and see. This is the group heal. Which I'd have to pay a chunk of change to get. Let's see, she's pretty much all on the back there. I'll just buff this. We'll just go with the single heal. I used to do a lot of group heals. So, I should have gotten this before I did anything else. Oh well. Live and learn. I guess I will go for it
now.
Some
may fall, but their knowledge lives on.
Let's see what I can get for this guy. Word reconstruction is pretty cool. I can't upgrade him because he's not level 1 yet. So, okay, well that's fine for now. Everybody else is in reasonably good shape. So I think we'll just take another run here. 90% of rooms, 90% of rooms. That's medium. I think I can do a medium. Get a swift cloak. And some extra money. Okay. She likes to be back there. He likes to be all the way in the back, right? Yeah. He can use that from the back as well. That's good. And Lepers are kind of a crapshoot. I don't know if they've been rebalanced at all for release. They're low accuracy, but they hit real hard. So they're kind of a risky, somewhat risky thing, risk-reward type deal. Alright, now we can camp. We're going to get one log, because this is a medium. Short missions, you don't get to camp at all. Medium missions, you get one bundle of wood to make a fire, so you can camp once, and long ones, you get two, so you can camp twice. Okay. This is a medium. That should be good. I will do two shovels. I'll do two shovels. And let's see, a lot of food. That should be good enough, right? Some bandages. Alright, that should be fine. That should be fine. I've spent enough money here. It's really easy to get carried away and spend a whole boatload of money on your provisions for a run, and sometimes that's great, sometimes it doesn't work out so well. Obviously, if you fail, it doesn't work out at all, because then you just spent a bunch of money and didn't get anything back. You can see the map here is much larger, so there's a lot more to cover. And this is explore 90% of rooms, so that's going to dictate how we traverse this. You want to do it in sort of the most effective manner without having to backtrack too much. Which kind of sucks here. I think we can just backtrack once for this area, and we shouldn't need to get this room. We can leave that alone, because it's only 90% of rooms, which usually means you can give up one room. So let's see how this goes. Nice. Let us go for... Well, I guess I don't need to stun him now. I don't... Would stun... If I stun him now... I'm going to test this because I don't remember the answer. If I stun him now... I assume that lasts until next turn. Even though he's already gone this round, I think it'll still work for me next time. Let's see, she can kill this dude. Confidence surges as the enemy. And that gives us a little bit of torch light up there. He can probably kill him too. Nice. A faint hope blossoms. Yeah, and he went first next time, and that didn't do him any good, so we're good. He doesn't need to do anything here, so I'll just cue these out of the way. Wow, awesome. Very cool. Is anybody even hurt? I don't think anyone's even hurt. Nope. So... Well, that went as well as it possibly could have. Them all. All right. Who can we stun? These guys have the same resist. What's their speed? Speed 2 and speed 5. I'll hit him. say he can blinding gas these two. Hopefully get the stun there. Yes. Oh, JC, man, you really should get this game. This is an awesome, awesome game. If you like XCOM, you'd probably like this. Not that they're exactly the same, but it has a similar vibe. It's like, it's a different type of tactical combat, but, you know, squad-based tactical combat. There is no save scumming this, though. This is like, you know, you can't take anything back. Like, it's always Iron Man all the time. But it's only $20, and there's a lot of content in here. Red Hook, the developer, is really cool. They've got more content on the way. There's like a free expansion pack that they're going to be working on. There's, you know, some more character classes coming. This is a really cool game, and for $20, it is a steal. Like, I would say this is a $40 game, easily. So. And since you're not super familiar with this, like the whole stress thing that's happening, like you see this extra bar down here, and she is like an enemy that stresses you out, and stress affects your characters negatively as they go. And then when you're back in town, you need to send them to the bar, send them to the church, do whatever to de-stress, and they can develop negative quirks, which are sort of permanent debuffs that, you know, are usually situational. Like if the torchlight is under a certain level or something, they'll react a certain way or things like that. So there's kind of a lot going on, but and it's a tough game. Like, it's pretty tough. Oh, is it 25 regular price? I thought it was 20. Ah, 20 as a launch discount. All right. I would take advantage of that if you think this game looks cool. I'm sure it'll go on sale at some point too, but I've had a ton of fun with this game, and it just came out of early access today. So their formation. There is no reason not to jump on board, if you ask me. Some people think it's too hard, but if you're playing XCOM and you like that a lot, this is probably up your alley, I would say. This is going well. This is going quite well. Get these out of the way. Not quite. CJ, that's what I was talking about earlier. You see how I tried to knock these out and it didn't quite happen. So sometimes it can be a little rough, although this does give me the chance to stun these two again. And she can... I don't have a stun with her. Okay, it was 20 in early access. Ah, shoot. Well, that'll at least give our leper here time to do his thing. Ah! That's the problem with the leper. He misses a lot. Let's see. Emboldening Vapors. It's damage and speed. Uh-oh. Please resist. Thank you. Alright, she can just do that one for the torch. There we go.
A trifling victory, but a victory nonetheless.
Oops, here's the key. We're gonna have to backtrack as it is, so maybe if I go like this, we'll just backtrack from here since we know there's no traps in this hallway, rather than risk backtracking. Not that I guess it matters, but this would be a potentially better scout chance anyway, if we happen to get a scout chance in that room. Okay, well, there was a trap there, so much for that.
Curious is the trap maker's art. His efficacy unwitnessed by his own eyes.
Where are we at? 68? I have one more. Nothing. No scout. That's a bummer. Altar of Light? I think I just tried this on its own last time. Plus 20 damage, that's good for him. I'm going to ignore the Iron Maiden. Actually, I want to say it's medicinal herbs you can use on an Iron Maiden. Yes! Cleanse the Maiden. Which sounds a little kinky. Okay. Alright. So far, so good. So you can see guys incur stress just as they're walking around, but you actually get more stress if you backtrack. So if you move backwards, and I believe if you walk back through an area you've already been to, you incur a little bit more stress than you would otherwise. I hate these dudes. Let's see if I can stun him. Good. Really hate those guys. Just go for the kill here. Can she? No. Alright. I will take that. And this is A-okay. Nice! Okay, and I'm out of room. I'll use a torch. Limited inventory space is also a major consideration in this game. As you can see, I am full up, pretty much. And like, this is only worth 250 gold. Whereas you can carry a lot of actual gold in one slot, so there's actually some strategy to inventory management in this, which is goes above what most games do. It's not just trying to fit everything in the most convenient way, but it's also kind of like trying to maximize your potential growth, knowing what's going to take up, you know, so much space, and how many things you're going to be able to stack in one slot. Stuff like that, the probability that you may use something like an antivenom versus another item type, which you will only really learn after you've been through each dungeon type and you know what kind of stuff you find in them, because these things are not necessarily universally useful. A lot of them, I think, are useful, you know, in multiple places, but you kind of get a sense of what's more likely to be helpful.
The way is lit. The path is clear. We require only the strength of...
Yeah, this is going really well, Idle. I'm pretty happy with how this is going so far. Still got a bit to go, but it's a straight run to the end. We still have our firewood. And this appears to be empty. Oh boy. Is anybody even remotely decent at trap? I don't think so. Not so much. Alright. I guess it's the Plague Doctor. Sorry, dude.
Ambushed by foul invention.
I can use a heal on him at some point. I think I'm just gonna avoid using torches for the time being. Hey, we got a scout. Awesome. Okay, this I think is new. This, I think, is new. Critical scouting success will sometimes reveal a secret room. Advance to the tile marked with a star and press W or click enter. Fabulous wealth and riches await those equipped with a key. Okay, so I'm fairly certain this is a completely new mechanic. I don't recall ever seeing this before. So apparently you need a key, and you have to get a critical on a scouting chance, which is interesting. So there's no fight up here, but there is one hall fight, and there's no fight here either. So we can go a ways before we use our firewood. That's one of the things with camping, is like knowing when to camp. You automatically get torched, so it's like I'll tend to let my light run a bit lower before I camp, if I'm trying to keep my light higher. There's a lot of different little things to consider. The actual basic game is really fairly simple, but there's lots of nuance to it, which is what's cool, because it's a very easy game to pick up and play, but it's a very difficult game to do well and really succeed in. Actually, let me stun this guy. What's that do? What's the difference between these two? Dazzling light, 80, minus 75. Oh, this is a stun. For some reason, I missed that she had a stun. Alright, well. Alright, man, let's do this! And see, now you get a goblet in your face. That's what happens when you miss. Okay. He already went. Maybe instead I will just... Now you know what? I hate these guys. Just get rid of him next turn. Ah! He resisted.
Such a terrible assault cannot be left unanswered.
It's fine. It's fine, Wayne June. Don't be so down. They've all gone, so I'll take this chance to heal him. You again? Can I kill either of these? 5 to 9 damage. I could potentially kill one or both. One is fine. I will take that. Man. She has nothing that's a stress heal, does she? No. Got the blight. That's for 4 damage, so it doesn't matter what we do. So he can heal up for 6. Doesn't matter what he does. This guy'll die next round.
Great is the weapon that cuts on its own.
Alright, we got a Drifter's Buckle. +10 trap disarm. Dodge. And a little bit less stress heal, that's pretty good. And I can't carry everything, of course not. So for instance, speaking of the inventory stuff here, like I have this jade, which is worth 250 gold, and I think, again, unless they've changed this balance-wise, I believe you can hold 4 gems per slot. So like Onyx, if you get 4 of those, that's 2K. And I think you can only do 1,500 gold in a slot, if I'm not mistaken. This may be at max. So, like, it would behoove me to just ditch this jade, because I have a higher potential for more gold to accumulate in that particular slot. So it gets a little tricky. But I think I will ditch that. And... maybe I'll ditch... I don't know if I want to ditch the anti-venom. He can heal blight. Alright, we'll ditch the anti-venom. And we'll take those. We got more stuff. That's okay, because we already had a slot for busts there. Oh, oops. I didn't even realize he was bleeding. How many more turns? one more round. I'm not gonna waste it. Not gonna waste anything on that. Let's see. I think I'm just gonna let the torch keep going. We don't have any more fights until this room, so we should be fine to just go all the way through. Get a free torch. Oh, that's interesting. In the past, I want to say that these only ever gave you just a free torch. That's all it was. But now we just got a Highwayman buckle, which is cool, except it means we need to ditch something else, which kind of sucks. Let's see, what does it do? -3% virtue chance, but +2% crit, and +5% stress damage. Wait, +5% stress damage? Meaning he takes more stress damage? And this is trap, disarm, and dodge, and less stress heal. I like that better. So, if that's just 2% crit for the other stuff, then I'm going to say screw it. Unless I'm reading that wrong. Because he doesn't really do stress damage, I mean, you know, so it must be damage received. And another one. Cool, got some onyx. Well, we can just use the torch. You can only carry 8 torches to a slot, so. In we go, and I think we will camp here, probably. I think that makes sense. We have 5 rooms to go. I could push my luck and make one more, because we do have decent health. Although he is a bit stressed. JC Man's a bit stressed. I guess I'll just do it here. We should be fine for 5 more rooms. We're doing pretty well. So we'll camp.
Circle in the dark. The battle may yet be won.
So yeah, this is the meal phase where you can either eat half rations, which gives you no bonus, or obviously if you have no food left, or if you so choose, you can starve, which is not great. It's less health and stress. You have a full meal, which gives you 10% health, and then a feast, which kind of makes everybody feel real good. We have a surplus of food and not that much more of this dungeon to go. You will don't want to use everything unless you're real close to the end, because you do get hungry as you're going and you need to eat, otherwise you will starve and take damage and stress. But I think we can afford to feast because we still have 8 food. So that's plenty. So we get a little bit of a stress heal there. And all of these guys have camping skills, which are separate from their combat skills. So like, our plague doctor here can do wound care, which is just a straight heal plus removes, you know, bleeding or blight. These vapors are 50% heal and extra heals received, and self-medicate, reduce stress by 10, heal 20%, and gives him a bonus to accuracy, I think, for 4 combats. I believe that's what the latest update did, is that you get any bonuses you get here, they last for 4 combats, not 4 rounds, but 4 actual fights, I believe. Let's see, she can reduce stress, dodge and accuracy. Pray, reduce stress by 15. If not religious, reduce stress by 5. That's not terrible. But you have this thing up here that's 12 with the hourglass. That's each of these things takes up so much. So this has 4 time cost. So you can't just use tons of these skills. That's kind of your limiter there. Bleed and blight, move and debuff resist. That's pretty cool. That seems like it's more than it used to be. I don't remember. Let's see. Oh yeah, 50-50 chance to... Huh. He suffers 20% HP damage, but everybody else has a chance to reduce quite a lot of stress. I'll do that. I don't think I've ever used that before. We can do pray with her. Nice. Get even a little more and see he can heal 50% and up the heals received. That's 4. Does she have a smaller one? Or does he? No. Reduce stress. Okay, it's all stress. Wound care. That's only cost 2. And that's 3. So I think I'll do that. And self-medicate so he doesn't need the heal, but he gets the boost to accuracy and the protection. So the boost to accuracy will be good because that'll help with his back rank stun. Okay, well, we're good. So now we rest and we hope we don't get ambushed. That's the other thing that kind of sucks, is you can get jumped as soon as you come out of this. And your party order gets rearranged and it's bad.
As the light gains purchase,
we're good.
Spirits are lifted and purpose is made clear.
Alright, let's roll on. And my torch went up to full, so that's why I wasn't using torches for that last bit there. Cool, we do have our holy water. Nice, look at all that stuff. So now that we have some extra room, we're getting jade again, but we can afford to, so that's okay. A shame that we dropped the other one, but it doesn't matter. Because this cash was still potentially going to be worth more. Yeah, I hear that. My dog is always bugging me right when I start streaming. She hears me talking and she's like, oh, you're talking to somebody. And that gets a little old. Alright, let's see if we can stun these guys. Got one. She can use this to potentially stun another one. I guess I'll do the one in the back again. Try. Since these guys are up front to deal with these. All them resists. Hewitt. Nope. Let's see what kind of damage it is. I can potentially kill either of these. Not quite, but... This game would probably make statistics professors really happy. Because it's a lot of just weighing the numbers, and like there's a lot of math in this game. Just like, well, he could do this much damage, but I have a higher chance of hitting with this other one. You know, and trying to figure out like who goes faster. This guy is this speed, this guy is that speed. Should I stun him or not? Oh, I'll go for another stun. Well, yeah. Nope. Okay, this would be the time for battlefield medicine, I guess. Cure that blight. Cute. There we go.
Ground quakes.
All right, he's blighted again. Man, bummer. Chop away. I could heal him here. He gets a self-heal thing. I don't know if it'll... I don't think it'll give me a penalty now. I don't think it will. Although it's probably not worth it, because this guy will probably go first. I think he's the fastest of everybody, and this guy won't be able to hit him. He's faster, but he doesn't have anything that can hit the front row, so it's actually better in this case to just try and kill this thing.
This
all right, very good.
Push on to the task's end.
Yeah, spiders can't read. Spiders don't care if you accuse them. They're like, I'm a spider. Whatever, man. Locked sarcophagus, and I don't have a key, so I don't remember what happens if you try to open one without a key. I want to say it's either a trap. I'm going to look that up. I'm going to look that up real quick. No item. You have potential for blight or bleed. So yeah, don't open a locked sarcophagus without something. Oh, you can use a shovel. Use a key or a shovel. I guess that might be worth it. Still, I have two shovels. There's no reason not to try, right? Yay! 50. Well, money's money. Okay, fight coming up here. Torch is still fine. Some more cash. He still does have the kleptomaniac. Ah, crap. Man, these things set in fast. I seem to remember them taking longer to do that. See, now this is like a, not a permanent trait, but it once it gets the skull icon, it's like locked in. It's like you have to spend a boatload of money to get those removed. Which is kind of unfortunate, but kleptomaniac, I feel like, used to trigger a lot more often. Ah, crap. These guys are new, the madmen. They came with not the release update, but the one that came before that, which had, I guess it was, I want to say the Abomination, the Collector, and the Madman all came at the same time. So, anyway, I haven't really seen what this guy can do. He looks like he's a stressor. Can I click on him and mouse over? No, that didn't work. Well, that sucks. I like his sound clips, those are pretty good. Chasey man, you think you're evil? Why do you say you're evil? You're the Crusader, man. You're a holy warrior. You're badass, but you're not evil. I guess I'll just go for the stun. Man! This guy is nimble. Hew these out of the way, I guess. And we should be able to make short work of this dude. Or not. Oh, the kleptomaniac, right, yeah. I guess that is a somewhat less positive trait. May as well take this opportunity to heal. Let's see, he's 21-33. He's 24-35. There we go. This has gone remarkably well. I'm very pleased with all this, and I think I can still, I can take all this stuff. Nice. We are maxed out on inventory, but nonetheless, still going pretty well. So, that's worth only 250 as well. I'm probably going to end up having to drop that. Okay, let's go for a stun. For a stun on you. Man, come on, stop stressing me out here. Guess I should have stunned the other guy. Let's see. I will stun him and then see if our plague doc can stun the two in the back. Good. He's gonna make someone bleed. That's okay. Guess we can use battlefield medicine. Heal that back up. They've lost their turn. We can heal our way through these. Ah, man! That's fine. She can try another stun. Good. Managing to get our stuns pretty well today. Yeah, sure. Water. Yeah, just go for it. let's see, she has 6 health and will take 4 damage. So she won't die next turn. So we'll just dang it, so when she do a little more damage than that, but crit heal is good. Take her out. Nope. That's not the way to do it. That's not the way to do it. Okay, we're good.
This expedition at least promises.
So now I'm going to dump this citrine because it's only worth 250, and you know I'm not super likely to find more of those. I'm more likely to find more gold. So, suit of armor. Let's have her go for it. Okay. Good deal. We got a scout. This doesn't look bad. Everybody eat. Still have tons of food. Which food also heals a small amount of health, so it's useful for that too, but it's not a lot. It's kind of a, if you have a massive surplus and you don't need it for anything else, it can be useful. What does this do again? Alchemy table. I can't remember what you use on an alchemy table. Use a torch. Or if that would like set it on fire and make you explode. Probably nothing would happen. I have tons of torches, I'll just try it. Hey! It actually did something! That was a blind guess. But I didn't even actually see what it did. did, specifically. Did it wasn't a buff? Did it give us an item? I don't think it gave us an item either. I have to go look it up now. Because I didn't catch that. Oh, I see. It just improves your torch. So my torch went back up to 100. So it's like using a torch to get bonus torch light, basically. Nope.
Mind Man. That such missteps are the exception and not the rule.
Let's see, stun. Stun. This team is working out better than I actually would have expected. So we can stun him too. Yeah, nice. There we go. I love the stuff the leper says. Rain in the forest, fog before sunrise. It's like a warrior poet or something. Just go for another stun on him. Nice dodge. Don't want any more stress, so I'll try and stun her. Nope. That's okay. Close, but no cigar. Well... Oh, thank God she dodged that. Hate that nonsense. Ugh. Alright, I'm gonna heal him. He should be able to do this. Just heal yourself, I guess. Yeah, what I was saying before, I think I never finished my thought, but there's a mechanic where if you get down to like one enemy and you're just kind of wasting time and trying to use it to heal yourself, since you can't heal outside of combat, people would abuse that and they would like just sort of cycle the round over and over again with like one guy left, and they would use, you know, their healer to just kind of keep healing over and over again. But now I believe there is a stress penalty that comes with that, which was added like a couple of patches ago. So that you can't abuse that. It will eventually start stressing everybody out because they're just sitting there not fighting. Okay, so I can't take this Onyx. That's worth 500. It's Emerald. It's 500 piece. 50 piece. Since we're right at the end of the dungeon, I will ditch the shovel. Oops, wrong button. There we go. Okay, last room. At least I hope so. This should be the last room.
Ancient traps lie in wait. Unsprung and thirsting for blood.
And let's...
In radiance, oh, may we find victory.
Nobody even here, so we're good. That was awesome. That was a great,
the great ruins
great run
to us, and we will find whatever secrets they hold.
So we got a boatload of money. We made basically 8 grand plus our quest reward. We got a ton of heirlooms. We did get this nice swift cloak. +2 speed, -20 move resist. Move resist being like those pulls and pushes that they do that like move you around the board. You have a resistance modifier for that, so this makes you more susceptible to being moved around, but it makes you faster. Yep, resolve level. I want to see if these have changed at all. Resolve XP for your success quest. In turn, determines the hero's resolve level, represents veteranship, directly acts as stress resistance against the horrors encountered in the dungeons. I don't know if I knew that or not. Low resolve level here, I'm not sure if I knew that it affected stress level. She won't drink in town, but she has a -20% weapon upgrade cost. That's nice. Same with him. Cool.
You answered the letter.
Most of the...
You are a part of this place.
Most of the trinkets, like the equipable stuff like that cloak and various things that you find, generally that's the way they work, is they carry like a bonus and a debuff of some kind. So it's usually like a trade-off. Like, you kind of end up building toward a certain thing, not necessarily with each individual character, because you end up with a lot of characters, so sometimes it's hard to keep track of exactly how you built them. But you can. You take certain skills and equip certain trinkets on them. You can kind of do different little builds with them, like, okay, well, this guy's speed doesn't matter, or whatever, so you don't worry about that. You just focus on other stuff to make up for it. But you can kind of play around with those, but it does require you to mess around a bit and sort of figure out how they work and how they best fit together. Idle Mind's Eye is tying one on and refuses to leave the bar yet. So he recovered 56 stress, but he's sitting in the bar for another... We can't use him for this next dungeon run. We have the Sanitarium now. Cove and the Warrens have been unlocked, which are other dungeon types. There are 5 dungeon types, I believe. And we got some people leveled up. It's pretty good. JC Man is the first to 2. But you're going to have to sit this next one out because you're a bit on the stressed out side here. So, Sanitarium. Maybe quirk 2 diseases. Also use it to reinforce a positive quirk, which will lock it into place, right? That hasn't changed. Lock a maximum of 3 positive quirks. So you can kind of use this to... If there's something you really want, like if you get new quirks, eventually they just cycle out, like the good ones. You'll have like 5 of them and you'll get another one and then it will replace one. But if you lock it in using the Sanitarium, then it won't get replaced. And you can also treat the bad stuff like JC Man. You have some bad things on you, like... is this how I do it? Yeah, so it costs 5 grand. It's a lot of money once they lock in with this skull icon, then that means they cost a ton to fix. So like getting rid of either of these would be massively expensive at this point, and it's not something I would want to do. Whereas like this guy, he's got this +20 stress if the torch is above 75. That's only 1500 to remove, so it's substantially cheaper. But his intense craving for alcohol is unfortunately locked in already. I haven't really figured out a great way to deal with this stuff. Like, it's really tricky. Like, this part of the game, you really have to think about what you're doing as far as who's going to go in for either stress removal or, you know, to treat a disease or a negative quirk or whatever. And... who's going to be available for the next, like, it's similar to XCOM in that way, I guess. Like, you know, when you have people who are out wounded, or who are in for some sort of upgrade that takes a number of days to complete, it's the same kind of deal with this, where you kind of have to consider, like, who's going to be available and who's not, and what party you're going to be able to build, because sometimes you will have guys that you can use, but they don't work well together. You know, they're all wanting to be in back or up front or whatever, and it can get kind of tricky. So, treatment library reduces the cost of quirk treatments. Medical devices reduces the cost of disease treatments, and the number of sanitarium slots will increase with this. I'd say that's probably pretty good.
The front line of this war is not in the dungeon,
so,
but rather inside the mind.
I'm going to try to keep up with reducing negative quirks this time around, because I really did not do that most of the time in like my previous plays. So I'm going to try to do that. It may not be worth it at this juncture. This guy's still kind of a lobby. So there is something to be said for just messing somebody up and then dismissing them. It is a perfectly viable strategy. So I'm going to hold off before I make that decision. See what else I can upgrade. We could do gambling. Could do gambling.
With enough ale, maybe they can be inured against the horrors below.
Is the game audio too low for you guys? Just out of curiosity. I haven't been paying attention to my levels here. And it's still all set up for XCOM. See, that's okay. Blacksmith. Deeds and crests. Okay. Reduce the cost of hero weapon armor upgrades. Guess we'll go with weaponsmithing. And who was it that got that buff? I think it was her. I want to say it was her. Yeah, it's normally 750. And for these guys, it's 600 to upgrade. So she's in great shape. She has no stress at all. So I will... because she has that quirk, that's why I chose it. Normally I would go armor first. But since she had the cost decrease that she got off that last run for weapons, I'll do that. Just because. JC man, I'm not going to bother with you just yet because you're going to have to do some de-stressing. And I can't upgrade these guys because they're still lobies. I could with him. It doesn't increase his accuracy, but it increases his crit base slightly and his potential damage by a little bit. It's always a tough call choosing where to spend your hard-earned cash, because it does not come easily sometimes. There's a lot of times when I have been straight up just out of money. Okay, sounds good. Alright, good. Alright, well, let's look at the stress relief options. JC Man has to pray, right? God-fearing will only pray for stress relief. Thankfully, that is open. Reduces treatment cost by 16% at the transept. I'm gonna go with that, since we have
in a robe.
One, maybe two guys that are godparent. So reducing madness. That is good. Alright. He needs to go somewhere. He needs to go somewhere. I guess the gambling hall it is. I can't upgrade that anymore. So just remaining intense screaming for Bravo. Well, before I commit to it, let's look at the stagecoach, see who else we got. We do have a new plague doctor. Weak grip on life, death blow. D resist and plus 20 stress damage and warrens. And he's got not the exact same skills. He's missing the back rank stun. But Nox's Blast is not bad either. Nox's Blast allows you to attack guys in the front row, which is handy. I think I will stick with this dude. I think I'm okay with that. I may take the other guy anyway, but I'm not going to dismiss the one that we got, I don't think. Our Houndmaster. Houndmasters are cool. Some people have said that they suck, but those people are crazy. Houndmaster is pretty good. Okay, plus 10 damage range skills. That's good. I think pretty much all of their skills are range skills. Blackjack is the only one that's not, other than these non-attack ones. So he's got the Hound's Rush, Hound's Harry, Target Whistle, and Cry Havoc. Alright. And our Man-at-Arms here. These guys are pretty cool. Claustrophobia, severe fear of enclosed spaces. Slugger, and Irrepressible. Okay. I don't know what claustrophobia does. I don't actually know what that does. Crush, Rampart. Alright, that moves him forward. Bellow is pretty cool. It's a nice, just big fat debuff on the opposing side. And Bolster for dodge and speed. Okay.
The raw strength of youth may be spent, but his eyes hold the secrets of 100 campaigns.
May as well just take everyone since we have the space here. Yeah, I don't know. It's got Wheel Tent, Hit, Tactician, Meditator, and minus 20 weapon upgrade cost. I guess it's worth it to keep him around. I guess it's worth it. Stick him in here to get rid of this. He's going to be out for another round as well, because I'm going to have to de-stress him on top of that. Jason Man's already doing his thing. Gordon. Don't really have to worry about getting rid of his stress necessarily. We got plenty of guys in here. Alright, well, I have been streaming for a couple hours here, so I'm going to take a quick break. I'll probably do, you know, another hour or something like that. So I will be back in you know, 5-ish minutes. I'll see you guys in a sec. All right, I'm back. Sorry about that. Took an extra second. I had to chop up a few dried New Mexico red chilies, which I got from the farm earlier this week, and needed to make some soup, which is currently going. So, all right, let's get back to it. Well, I have a lot of money. I'm definitely not hurting money-wise, which is cool. I like to have a bit of a surplus. Things have gone swimmingly thus far. I think what I'm going to do is... Actually, I can't. I still only have one slot there. That's a shame. That is a shame. Well, let's just... She's already gotten her upgrade. I can't upgrade my armor. Or that's not where this is. Blacksmith. Can't upgrade the armor smithing, which I really wish I could. I need deeds for that, and deeds, I believe, are the wield. If I'm not mistaken, yes, they are. The wield is unpleasant. Oh snap, look at that. There is nothing available in the ruins. Now this is different. I don't think there ever used to be a point where there was not some sort of, you know, activity available everywhere. It wouldn't always be one you would want to take. I think sometimes there would be ones that were like, it was just too high level, you know, like level 3 or something. But I don't recall ever seeing it where there just wasn't anything, but maybe that's a New Balance change where they're like, you've been hanging out in the ruins for a while, you need to go somewhere else. That is interesting and potentially terrifying, because the ruins are far and away the least scary place on the whole. Wield has some kind of nasty stuff in it, but I guess it's time we showed off something new anyway. So we got complete 100% of rune battles. Short, we get some deeds, which we need, and an archer's ring, which is not bad. So, question is, who do we send? Probably this guy, because there is a lot of blight in the wield. Our healer's doing fine. She's light sensitive, but she's not a huge damage dealer anyway. And I don't care about any of that, so I'm not too worried. We could send... I think I'm going to take Gordon out, because I'm not sure if this will solidify if they stay in town or only after they've gone on runs. I don't know how that works, but... let's see, this dude, he kind of wants to be in the back. Yeah, he kind of wants to be in the back. So, not him, perhaps. She kind of does too. I don't know that I like her. She's got a weird combo of skills. But she is a little bit more based on like actually moving through the group. So, no on him. Yeah, this guy. He'll work. Scouting chance in Cove. We're not going to the Cove yet. I don't even want to go anywhere near the Cove. Right now, that place is... That place is not okay. He's got duelist advance, so that's good. If he gets pushed back, he can move forward. And he has something he can do up at the front, so that's fine. We don't have to worry about camping right now. And this guy will probably go up front. Yeah. Now let's open our trinket selection here and see... Got the protection stone. Just unequip everything, make everything available here. So we don't have bounty hunter, we do have a highwayman. That is trap, disarm, and dodge. So that is a-okay. And more speed, less move resist. He does have something that'll let him move, so that's okay for him, I think. Minus 10 stress damage. That's just solid for everybody. Maybe do that for her, and accuracy, let's dodge. Do that for this guy, I guess. Minus speed. What is his speed? 3? Is it 7? Give him one of those. He's already slow. This should be fine. Okay. Let's see how horrible this goes. I don't know why we got one anti-venom, and I don't know if certain characters bring certain things, or if it's just like a chance, or really have no clue how that new mechanic works. I want a couple of shovels, because there's stuff in the wield. He does have battlefield medicine, which is good, but I still probably want to bring a couple anti-venoms. I'll still bring a couple bandages, one medicinal herb, one key. Twelve food. Yeah, okay. Well, this was 100% of room battles. A couple extra torches. Alright. So there's different enemies. Some enemies will cross over different dungeon types. You do see plenty of recurring enemies, but you also get specific ones as well.
The soil, sapping all good life from these groves. Let us burn out this evil.
So this one has like these weird fungal things that are terrible, and I want to say this is bandages? Yeah. Ooh, that money. That money.
Nature herself.
Use a shovel on this.
To the spreading corruption, malformed with misintent.
Nice. Surprised. So these guys are unique to this area. Well, I don't know if they ever show up anywhere else, to be honest. I don't remember. So I can plague grenade this back guy, or I think these are resistant to plague. Yes. But I can... This will probably... Well, yeah, that's not great either. That's a minus 80% damage. I guess it's still better, because it'll hit 2, and... Eh. Maybe just emboldening vapors is better. Can they bleed? They resist bleed also. Nice! Dang! Wow. Well, this is one of the things that sucks about these guys is they can make more of themselves. So that's a little frustrating. But they're not super tough otherwise. But there are larger versions of them as well, so... Man! That dude is on fire!
Be wary. triumphant pride precipitates a dizzying
fall. I'll save my skeleton key. Okay. This is an unpleasant group. This is a very unpleasant group. I do not like this. I do not like this at all. Do not like this at all. And those are highly resistant to blight. It's one of the disadvantages of plague doctors. And you can only attack the front. Well. Just boost his speed up again. He at least can do this duelist advance. This is where this comes in handy because it jumps him one forward. So that is very helpful. It's just explaining that high protection means it's like high armor, basically. But you can use things like bleed and blight to take dudes out a little bit faster. Bellow will reduce dodge and speed. I think I'm gonna do that here just to try and make future turns a little bit easier. She can stun this one. Plague grenade. Good. Blight is really useful. I really enjoy blight. I've gotten a lot of mileage out of that in that many times. let's see if we can. Well, there's no way to take him out, but I really want him to die. Maybe I can use. I could kill her, potentially. I can go with him. Nice! Crit. And hopefully I can kill him before he gets to go. Yeah, there we go. It's only a 65% chance to hit, though. Go for it. Yes! Very good. Very good. And she got a crit heal on herself, which is awesome. Alright, well, we'll just slam these guys in the head. That's why I have his nice duelist advance here. It's great for stuff like that. Well, just keep the buff on him. And I don't even have to worry about the cultist because she's going to die from the blight the next time she gets to go. Because there's one more round and she's got 2 health. go with the stun on this dude. Nope.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted.
It's fine.
And purpose is made clear.
Kill him. And she will die. Be nice if we could get a heal off before that. Yeah, cool. That was great. Snowman. And she's toast.
Gently. This is how a life is taken.
We got another key too. So what the heck order did I have these guys in again? He was in the back. I think this is what it was. Yeah. Okay, we're good. We're gonna have to do some backtracking here, which kind of sucks. Beast carcass, I want to say medicinal herbs? Yep. And we get some... Whoa. Holy smokes. I was going to say we get some food. That's more than some food. It's too bad this isn't a camping trip. Shallow grave? Don't remember. Gonna ignore it. I think you can use a shovel, but I want to save that shovel for removing obstacles in the future. Nobody here? Troubling effigy. This I don't remember. Maybe we can torch it? No. I'm just gonna leave it alone then. Don't think it was anti-venom. Yeah, try it. Yeah, I didn't think so. Alright, screw it. We're just gonna ignore it. Uh-oh. Well, this is not great. No, this is not great. This is super not great. It's especially frustrating, too, because I could use his Duelist Advance to swap with him, but then he's also got a move that lets him move forward one, so they would just continually loop, and that would be pointless. So we will Pistol Shot. Nice. Oh, yeah, push him. Push him, please. Please do. Excellent. Sometimes that works in your favor. And we can get him right back up to the front with this. So that was pretty alright. That was pretty alright. Just emboldening vapors, I guess. She can just... Nothing. I'm just gonna do this. We'll let our highwayman move up on his own here. Keep everybody in the right order. Nice, man! I don't know how you pronounce this guy's name. Montague?
These nightmarish creatures can be felled.
He is can be beaten. With the crits, man. Empty sack. Gonna resist the urge to make a vasectomy joke. I should have changed their order. That was foolish. That's fine. That's fine. I do that sometimes. I forget to change the order when I should. I think these resist. No, not heavily. Resist.
Unnerved, unbalanced.
That was a bad crit. That was pretty bad. That was pretty bad. He'll die from the blight, so... Okay, how many rounds? Yes, I know he's blighted. Two rounds, only one damage. I'm not going to worry about it. Well, no, just slice it. There we go.
Death. Unforeseen.
The only problem with that is that my play doctor didn't get a chance to go, so he can't cure. Normally he can cure blight, and she's at five rounds of one damage. So I'm going to have to use an antivenom for that. Deteriorating Bracer. Plus 10 dodge of HP above 75%. Minus 6 of HP below 50. That's crazy. That is real crazy. I kind of like that, though. Give that to this dude. She needs to use the antivenom. And we have a crap load of food, so I'll hold off. No, I'll just use at least a couple on her. That's fine. She can get healed up next time. Hunger. Everybody eat. Is that a blight trap? Damn it. Oh, really? That sucks. That sucks a bunch. 6 damage. Alright, well, do it.
The match is struck. A blazing star is born.
Zombie dogs. These guys suck a bit. I hate getting surprised by these guys. And he can't use battlefield medicine from here. And these are blight resistant. I'm just gonna move him. Do I have a bandage? I do have a bandage. It's only 2 more damage. But he's so low, I'll use it. Duelist advance. That was really stupid. I should have gone on one of these other ones. Oh well. Wouldn't have killed it anyway. Let's see, we will bellow at these dudes. Oh man, that's a shame. At least we killed one, but that's a shame. It's great when these guys have less speed. Now they're probably going to get to go before us all again. Ugh, man. So this is an example of how fast this game can go south. Sometimes these guys aren't a problem, but if it goes wrong, sometimes it's just bad. Sometimes it's just bad. Okay, battlefield medicine time. They've already gone. Go with the heal. They really like going for the guys in the back, apparently. Which is exceedingly frustrating. Ugh. Hoping for a crit there. No crit, sadly. But we still get him. Oh, no, we don't. Say we still get to get him before he goes, but we don't. It's not always advantageous to heal this way. But sometimes it can you're essentially not really gaining ground, but you might be spreading the damage out.
And insidious killer.
Oh, nice. We're done. Really? That doesn't seem right. Huh. I guess there was no battles down those two. Well, cool. I don't remember what you do with the ancient coffin. Gotta look that up. Try not to look up everything, but things that I feel like I should remember, but I used to know. Oh, this one doesn't use an item at all. That's strange. I wonder if that's different. I don't recall. So we can either get good quirks, loot, or nothing. Okay, well, do it. So we got Wheeled Adventure. Which, what does that do? Minus stress damage. Good. Yeah, well, that went pretty well. We didn't get a ton of loot. And people are still sort of okay. I don't... This is a point where you could say, do I bail or do I stick around and try to get some extra rewards? We know there's no more room battles, but there might still be more loot, and these guys have low stress, so, well, we walked straight into a battle here, but I think that's probably fine. Sometimes it ends up being to your advantage to kind of stick around and whatever, since these guys aren't particularly stressed out and they're not, like, in dire straits health-wise. I feel totally fine with sending them out a little bit further here.
In Radiance, may we find victory.
Health is easy to replenish because if you survive the mission, you're good to go. But stress, that's another matter entirely. So there's a lot to be said for killing off these enemies that cause stress. Since I can just bail on here basically at any time, I don't have to worry that much about my health. Because, you know, nobody's really bad off here. Bummer. But you definitely don't want to accrue more stress needlessly, because it's great that these guys don't have any. It means I can just send them right back out without having to waste any time. Their health will automatically regenerate as soon as they get back to town. But, which is different from XCOM, where, you know, you get injured and then you're out for so much time. That doesn't happen here. Just the stress that's the problem. And I am going to incur a bit of stress because I am, you know, spending more time in the dungeon and walking back here. But, you know, it's not a lot. Unless we run into a really bad fight with, like, some nasty stuff. This is really pretty okay. And then there's that.
Curious is the trap maker's art.
She resisted the blight.
His efficacy unwitnessed by his own eyes.
We don't have any bandages, so I'm gonna leave that alone. Another fight. Nice.
Quakes.
Very nice. See if we can get this guy in one hit. Yeah, there we go. I'm liking this more all the time. I resist stun, so I'm not gonna bother. Just go with the heal. There may be a fight in this room right behind him, so having a little extra health would not hurt at all. I don't know, JC, man. I may stream some XCOM tonight. I don't know. I can't be sure of that. I'll probably call it quits here after this run. since we're nearing the 3 hour mark.
As victories mount,
I do have some work to do today, so I can't say 100% if I'll be streaming tonight, but I might, because I am super addicted to XCOM right now. Yeah, I'll stop this after this run, I think. Free torch, which I don't really need. So this is why I like to push on sometimes, because we got some stuff out of this. We definitely got a lot more gold, and we're still okay, so we use one last torch, fight the last fight if there's one in here, and if not, we bounce. Cool.
Driving out corruption is
that was nice.
Battle, but one that must be fought.
I'm in Northern California, JC man. So, Pacific time. At some point, I will probably set up a schedule. I just haven't gotten around to it yet, and I've got kind of a lot of other stuff on my plate at the moment, so it'll be a little while before I figure that out. Alright, yeah, that was great. Deadly. Plus one crit. Obsessed with food? I don't think I've seen that one before. Cityomania. Wow. And plus 10 damage if torch below 26. Cool.
All the decadent horrors I've seen pale in comparison to that final.
Idol is finally done with his drinking.
I could not look, nor could I look away.
JC Man's good to go. This dude has removed his negative quirk. We did get some guys up to level 1, which means we can buy them some gear. And I got 22 grand, which is pretty decent for early game. I feel like I usually have less gold than this on my past runs. So I feel pretty good about the way this has started. We did lose someone early on, but that happens. It's not as big of a deal. I feel like it's a bigger deal in XCOM when you lose somebody than this game. Like, I feel that harder in XCOM. It's like, oh man. But in this, it's like, well, you win some, you lose some, because you will have party wipes in this. Like, it is unavoidable. You are just going to lose completely, which is really frustrating. I've seen other streamers play this and have a party wipe, and they lose like three or four level 6 dudes, which is like the max level. You know, all buffed out with all their equipment upgraded and everything, plus with like ancestral level, you know, like legendary trinkets that are really hard to get, and just lose all of it. So this game can be brutal. There was something going around for a while where there's some dude who like smashed his keyboard, like picked it up and smashed it. I don't remember the specifics, but there's definitely been some rage associated with this game. And there are definitely people on Steam who are like, fuck this game, it's too hard. You know, they've made it just ridiculously hard, and I don't really think any of that's true, but yeah, but it is a hard game, and it's meant to be a hard game. Let's see. No, that's the wrong place. I'm going to send him there. Where's the Abbey? Send him there. Don't need to upgrade that anymore. Everybody else is really kind of alright. I don't feel like I need to do anything. except I was, I think it was it you? Yeah, it was him. Just gonna ditch that. Take that out while it's cheap. And, I guess we could decide, well, let's see who's in the coach here. Let's see, I could get another barracks, but I want to be able to upgrade their armor, so I may not do that just yet, because I think that also takes deeds, if I am not mistaken. Yes, it does. Need 10 of those. Don't have any portraits, so I can't do anything there. Okay, I think... trying to remember exactly how this works. It's like everything takes crests and something else, I guess is how this works. Yeah, everything takes crests and then one of the other three. So crests are sort of your universal upgrade item, but then you specifically need you know, these other three for specific buildings. So we're not going to do any more upgrading. I could, I guess, upgrade combat skills. I do like all of this stuff. I love Zealous Accusation. That's a great skill. So I may bump that up. Idol, what can we do with you? I like all these skills as well. Tend to use Grapeshot a lot. This ups the accuracy and the crit potential. Maybe I'll hold off on that. I used her a whole bunch. She could get a little more stun base. A little more accuracy on that. Sure. This will give us slightly more to the dodge debuff. And a little torch as well. I don't want to commit to anything. Alright, well, I think that will do it. So yeah, thanks guys. It was a very good time. I had fun. It's nice to get back into this game. I know Idle has it, and JC Man, I totally recommend you pick this up if it looks like something you're into. I think this is a fantastic game. I've had a whole lot of fun with it. Like I said, I've already put 48 hours into it or something like that before I just started this run at various different times in the game's early access development, so I kind of got to see it from the ground up. I was a Kickstarter backer. So, but yeah, totally pick it up. Check it out. I think it's great. I'll probably stream some more of it. I'm going to go harder at XCOM, I think, because I really want to finish XCOM before XCOM 2 hits. But I'll probably have this in my rotation, you know, a few times a week or something like that. So, yeah, I guess if you guys... Obviously, Idle, I won't be seeing you later, because I know you're not going to have any way to watch me later. But, JC Man, I might see you later. I will have this up on YouTube at some point, as always. So, I will see you guys next time. Cheers.